Hey, I'm Martin Bobman with Focal. Today I'm going to talk about customer journeys and why it's important to get yours right as a photographer. If you've ever noticed your website's getting traffic, but it's not leading to any bookings, this is why. Figuring out your customer journey can go a long way to solving that. You might think your customer journey is simple. People go to your website, they book you, you get paid. But it's a lot more than that. It's about planning your customer's experience at every step of the way. Your customer journey covers every single interaction or touch point you have with a client. Getting it right is about making sure they're confident and you're leading them on a clear path. Think for a second about how people actually find you and your photography. They're not just typing letters at random and coming up with your URL. They're also probably not landing right on your booking page. They're finding you somewhere else first. That's where your customer journey starts. Today, I'm going to focus on three steps you can take to master your customer journey. These changes will help you get more inquiries and more bookings than before. And they don't take days or even hours to implement either. You can get started with a few simple steps. One of the first places people usually find you is social media. Now that could be Facebook, but that's probably Instagram. Maybe you popped up in their Discover feed or you've been advertising to get eyes on your profile. But now you have to think about what to do with them from here. One of the biggest mistakes I see is the Instagram DM for bookings message. You'll see this a lot, and I get it. It at least starts some kind of conversation. But you haven't covered anything to do with what your packages look like, your prices, nothing. There's too much information missing. There's not enough to make a consistent sale. Now you might sell photo shoots going down this route. If your work is good, people will DM you. But now you've got to spend extra time responding to every client who still has a million questions. And not every client's going to want to book you. Now that's time wasted on a vanishing lead. Thinking about your customer journey means giving them the right information at the right time. On your social media, that means a few things. Telling them what kind of shoots you offer, where you're based, and where they can book you. And that usually means linking to your website. But you don't want to just send them to your homepage either. Send them to a booking page, somewhere that's getting them closer to booking a shoot. The second step to mastering your customer journey is about solving your website's mess. You want clients to find what they're looking for without having to read every single page of your website, because they won't. It doesn't matter how well you've curated every last photo in your gallery. Well, it matters, but it's not the main thing. What matters is making it easy for someone to find what they came for. You want to know the biggest way to improve your booking rate on your website? Make your categories clear and segmented so everything's easy to access. If I want to book you for headshots, I don't want to have to scroll through your wedding and family photos first. I came for the headshots. Show me the headshots and make it easy for me to book them. Again, it's about giving your clients the right information at the right time. That means a few things. What packages you offer, what they cost, what's included, and what makes you and your work different. I'll show you what that looks like on the Focal storefront. Here is Greg Samborski's portfolio. If I came for headshots, here it is. And all those questions we were just talking about are answered right here. I don't have to jump around from a portfolio page to a pricing page. And I don't have to find my way from there to a booking page or contact form either. It's all laid out. Dead simple. I know everything I need to book him. And from there, I just message him. There's no hidden pricing and there's no maze to figure out how and where to reach him. There's a third part of your customer journey to consider. What happens after they book you? What happens after the shoot? How do you deliver the photos to them? Being upfront and transparent about those things gives your customers confidence, but it also allows you to think ahead about where you can benefit too. Let's say you've had the shoot. They love the photos. How do you get them to leave a review? How do you get them to book you again? A well thought out customer journey keeps the long run in the picture. And the more you practice, the smoother it'll be for you and every customer you get from here. That's all today. Hope that helps with your photography business. If you want more, head to bookfocal.com/blog. There's lots of photography business advice there. We also offer a free photography business accelerator program. It can help you focus on your ideal clients and how to reach them. If you found this helpful, hit subscribe, hit that thumbs up button. We'll be back next week with more. Until then, I'm Martin Bauman for Focal. Thanks for watching.